How might I help you?
How much money are you planning to leave me when you die?
Nice talking to you. Want to try that again?
I need to buy a computer so I can solve the Navier-Stokes equation. Apple has a nice one for $2,000, but the kind I need costs $3
million. Let me see. Oh, look at that. A peso.
It's warm.
Yeah, I know those sort of problems. For my research, I do theoretical astrophysics. So what that involves is like simulations of the universe, and these things are enormous. And you need supercomputers to process these things. So these supercomputers are incredibly expensive, millions of dollars. So these Navier-Stokes equations are like a really accurate way to calculate how fluids move. And they're super important in our world. They've led to things like passenger jets, submarines, Formula One cars staying on the track at high speed, medical advances in blood flow through veins and arteries, all kinds of things. And if you can prove whether smooth solutions always exist in three dimensions, or provide a counterexample, you can win $1 million US. It's considered one of the seven greatest mathematical unresolved problems currently. The reason he needs a computer is because in practice, these coupled differential equations are just way too hard to solve by hand. So the way we usually do it is with our computational fluid dynamics, CFD, and there's these computational methods for solving them.
This isn't working.
I disagree.
Mr. Einstein, I'm very excited to talk to you, but I was hoping to hear from Thoth, the...
Where is the fun in finding things out if some joker with a bird head just tells you the answer? Answers are all well and good, but a real scientist loves the thrill of the chase. Am I right, Hawken?
I would agree.
Unified field theory would explain the
That's one of my favorite quotes by, Feynman on the wall. What is it? Do whatever you love in the most original, irreverent, and undisciplined manner possible. If you go about things like that, passion always stays alive.
But what if I never figure it out?
I never did, and my scientific clay is nothing to sneeze at.
Same here.
Agreed.
If I was offered a choice between all the knowledge of the universe or the endless pursuit of it, I would choose the pursuit.
I wouldn't.
That's very insightful.
I've always loved trains. In fact, if my career in theoretical physics hadn't worked out, my backup plan was to become a professional ticket taker. Or hobo.
Me too.
I don't care how dim-witted you are, scientific principles have to make you smile. Of course, nobody I knew in East Texas in 1989 cared about Newtonian physics.
I can certainly relate to Sheldon growing up in a family that knows nothing about science. That was me growing up. My family knows nothing about science, and they still don't. I was nothing like Sheldon. I was very quiet. When I was a kid, I didn't think I was smart enough to be a physicist. I remember being in like year 8, and I was in this biology class, and I come from a family, no one's been to university, no one knows anything about science. And I remember thinking, wow, to do biology at university, you must be a genius. There's so many people out there, even in physics, that have this thing called imposter syndrome, where no one feels like they deserve to be there. No one feels like they're smart enough to be there. And it's a massive problem. But it didn't stop me. You know, I watched like every space documentary I could find. I was obsessed.
What's your first class?
Solid state physics at 11:30.
Oof. It's a tough one.
Thing to DeBroid, lambda equals h divided by m times what? Sheldon.
Is it velocity?
Yes. Now.
Or is it a velociraptor?
Sorry?
Perhaps lambda equals h divided by m times a velociraptor. Or a velveteen rabbit.
Is this from your philosophy class?
Philosophy.
Do you really believe that De Broglie's equation contains Velveeta cheese?
De Broglie was a cool guy. He actually proposed that electrons might have both waves and particle properties. So they might be both waves and particles. And his famous equation actually describes the wave properties of matter, specifically an electron. And he actually has this really cool quote that I've always loved. It's something like, we're not sufficiently astonished by the fact that any science might be possible.
Elon, the CNN reporter's here to talk to you.
Hang on. Send him in.
Classic. So if you didn't know, Elon did physics at university as well. And so did Jeff Bezos before he switched to, I think, computer science and politics. So there's a bunch of other people as well who did physics at uni who ended up with a lot of money. So if you want to be rich, go study physics.
Mr. Cooper, welcome. How can I help you?
I would like to drop your class.
How was your first day?
Infuriating.
My mom always tells this story, how I came home from school one day. I was in like grade one. And apparently I was like, I can read, I can write, just need to learn a little bit more math and then I'm finished with school. And I hated school. So my mom then says, you know, how depressed I was when, you know, she told me how much longer I had to go. And yeah, I guess that's another difference. Like when I was young, I hated school.
Welcome to the world of philosophy. Most college courses are about teaching you things that you don't know. Here, I'm going to teach you that you don't even know what you think you know.
If you study physics at university, you'll inevitably learn this because they kind of crush everything you thought you knew. I have a major problem with Sheldon's character. I think he doesn't embody a good scientist. And I think a lot of people will look at Sheldon and think, you know, that's how scientists think about the world and that, you know, they're obsessed with facts, but that's really not it at all. The best scientists out there don't hold on to any ideas in science, any facts, any theories, very concretely at all. And you can easily just break their reality with a good experiment, with new evidence, and they will just jump ship. The reason for this is probably best explained with this little overview of the history of physics. So along came Aristotle. He said a bunch of things that were wrong. Then Galileo and Newton came along, fixed everything up. Then along comes Einstein, breaks everything again. And now we've pretty much got it all worked out. Except for small stuff, big stuff, hot stuff, cold stuff, fast stuff, heavy stuff, dark stuff, turbulence, and the concept of time. So don't be too sure of what you think you know. I'm sure there's lots of kids out there like young Sheldon over here, but I think a lot of the ones that end up going to science are just pretty normal kids. So yeah, if you're a young kid watching this and you're not like Sheldon, you're nothing like him, don't worry. You don't need to be like Sheldon to do what Sheldon does. I was nothing like him, and I don't think many people I know in physics were like Sheldon as a kid.
If you want to be like Sheldon and learn some physics, but you don't know where to start or you think it's too hard, Brilliant is a great option because it makes it fun and easy. Brilliant have sponsored this video, so big thank you to them. Trying to learn physics by just watching, it's a bit like trying to learn how to ride a bike by watching someone else ride a bike. Learn interactively with Brilliant's fun hands-on lessons in math, science, and computer science. There's been some work to show that learning interactively actually helps you learn 6 times more effectively than just watching lecture videos. Join millions of people already learning on Brilliant with a special offer just for you guys. Head to brilliant.org/DylanJDance to get started for free learning with Brilliant's interactive lessons. The first 200 listeners will also get 20% off an annual membership. So thanks again to Brilliant. Check them out if you want to learn some physics. Let's get back to the video.
So if you're having a tough time at school and no one's really like you, just hang in there and feel free to come follow me on Instagram. Give me a message. I'm more than happy to give advice and, you know, just be a friendly voice.